गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, नाउ द रिमेनिंग पार्ट ऑफ द कोलाइडल स्टेट मीन्स सरफेस केमिस्ट्री। इन दिस वीडियो लेक्चर यू विल स्टडी अबाउट द प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ कोलाइडल सॉल्यूशन। सिंस यू हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द डेफिनेशन ऑफ कोलाइड्स एंड अदर टर्म्स रिलेटेड टू सरफेस केमिस्ट्री, इन दिस वीडियो you will study about the properties of colloids. The most important properties of colloids are kinetic property, optical property and electrical property. Kinetic property in this property the Brownian motion means the movement of colloidal particle in zigzag motion or zigzag path will be discussed. So this is the Brownian motion. Brownian motion means zigzag movement of colloidal particle. So what is the reason for Brownian motion? This is due to the unequal bombardment of particles of dispersed phase particles of dispersion medium and the particles of dispersed phase. So what is the meaning of dispersed phase and dispersion medium in colloidal solution? Dispersed phase means distributed phase and dispersion medium means continuous phase. Just like in case of solution, solute and solvent, in colloidal solution, solvent is referred as dispersion medium and solute as dispersed phase. So dispersed phase plus dispersion medium gives colloidal solution. So Brownian motion is the zigzag motion of colloidal particle due to unequal bombardment of the particles of dispersion medium and the particles of dispersed phase. This motion provides stability to the colloidal solution because kinetic property provides continuous motion for the particles of colloidal solution. That is why it prevents the precipitation of colloids or colloidal solution. So this is all about Brownian motion. What is Brownian motion? Zigzag motion of particles of dispersed phase in colloidal solution, and this is due to unequal bombardment of particles of dispersion medium and the particles of dispersed phase. And this property of colloidal solution provides stability to the colloidal solution. Next property, the optical property. In this property, Tyndall effect is discussed. What is Tyndall effect? When light is passed to the colloidal solution in dark, colloidal solution kept in dark, and beam of light is passed to the colloidal solution, and by observing with the help of microscope, one can see clear path of the light in colloidal solution. This phenomena is known as Tyndall effect because of the name of the discoverer. Brownian motion and Tyndall effect is the property which is known on the name of the discoverers. Brownian motion discovered by Robert Brown, while the Tyndall effect discovered by Tyndall. So what is the reason for the Tyndall effect? Tyndall effect is due to the scattering of light by colloidal particle. Since the size of colloidal particle ranges from 1 nanometer to 1000 nanometer, this size is suitable for the scattering of light. Due to the scattering of light, Tyndall effect is observed. So Tyndall effect is optical property. And Brownian motion is काइनेटिक प्रॉपर्टी। नेक्स्ट इज द इलेक्ट्रिकल प्रॉपर्टी। अंडर दिस प्रॉपर्टी इलेक्ट्रोफोरेसिस, स्पेशल टर्म इज इलेक्ट्रोफोरेसिस, दिस इज डिस्कस्ड अंडर द प्रॉपर्टी इलेक्ट्रिकल प्रॉपर्टीज। व्हाट इज द इलेक्ट्रोफोरेसिस? मूवमेंट ऑफ कोलाइडल पार्टिकल इन द इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड टूवर्ड्स कैथोड और एनोड। व्हाट इज द इलेक्ट्रिकल प्रॉपर्टी और इलेक्ट्रोफोरेसिस? माइग्रेशन ऑफ द कोलाइडल पार्टिकल टूवर्ड्स कैथोड और एनोड इन द इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड इज नोन एज इलेक्ट्रोफोरेसिस एंड इट इज मे बी ऑफ टू टाइप्स, कैटाफोरेसिस एंड एनाफोरेसिस। व्हेन द कोलाइडल पार्टिकल मूव टूवर्ड्स कैथोड इट इज नोन एज कैटाफोरेसिस एंड व्हेन द कोलाइडल पार्टिकल मूव टूवर्ड्स एनोड कॉल्ड एनाफोरेसिस। कैटाफोरेसिस शोन बाय पॉजिटिव कोलाइड्स एंड एनाफोरेसिस बाय नेगेटिव कोलाइड, बिकॉज कैटायन मूव टूवर्ड्स कैथोड एंड एनायन मूव टूवर्ड्स एनोड। सिंस इन कोलाइडल सोल्यूशन कोलाइडल पार्टिकल्स एक्वायर आइदर पॉजिटिव चार्ज और निगेटिव चार्ज, ओनली वन टाइप ऑफ चार्ज पोसेस्ड बाई ऑल द कोलाइडल पार्टिकल्स, आइदर पॉजिटिव और निगेटिव। फॉर एग्जाम्पल फेरिक हाइड्रोक्साइड साल्ट, फेरिक हाइड्रोक्साइड साल्ट इज एन एग्जाम्पल ऑफ पॉजिटिव कोलाइड। ड्यूरिंग इलेक्ट्रोफोरेसिस ऑल द पार्टिकल्स ऑफ फेरिक हाइड्रोक्साइड साल्ट मूव टूवर्ड्स कैथोड बिकॉज इट इज पॉजिटिव कोलाइड। सो पॉजिटिव कोलाइड मीन्स फेरिक हाइड्रोक्साइड साल्ट शोस कैटाफोरेसिस एंड आर्सेनियस सल्फाइड साल्ट और मेटेलिक सॉल, आर्सेनियस सल्फाइड साल्ट इज एन एग्जाम्पल ऑफ निगेटिव सॉल्ट। इट मीन्स ऑल द पार्टिकल्स ऑफ आर्सेनियस सल्फाइड साल्ट कंटेन्स निगेटिव चार्ज, मीन्स दे आर निगेटिवली चार्ज पार्टिकल कोलाइड्स। सो ड्यूरिंग द इलेक्ट्रोफोरेसिस ऑल द कोलाइडल पार्टिकल्स ऑफ आर्सेनियस सल्फाइड साल्ट मूव टूवर्ड्स एनोड बिकॉज निगेटिव आयन मूव टूवर्ड्स एनोड, मीन्स एनायन टूवर्ड्स एनोड। इन अदर वर्ड आर्सेनियस सल्फाइड साल्ट शोस एनाफोरेसिस। सो द कैटाफोरेसिस एंड एनाफोरेसिस ऑल टूगेदर इज नोन एज इलेक्ट्रोफोरेसिस। इलेक्ट्रोफोरेसिस इज इलेक्ट्रिकल प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ कोलाइडल सोल्यूशन। सो व्हाट इज द इंपॉर्टेंस ऑफ इलेक्ट्रोफोरेसिस? इलेक्ट्रोफोरेसिस कन्फर्म्स दैट ऑल द कोलाइडल पार्टिकल्स कंटेन्स आइदर पॉजिटिव और नेगेटिव चार्ज। सिंस लाइक चार्ज रिपेल ईच अदर मीन्स आइडेंटिकल चार्ज ऑन द कोलाइडल पार्टिकल प्रोवाइड्स एक्स्ट्रा स्टेबिलिटी टू द कोलाइडल सोल्यूशन। नेक्स्ट टर्म इज इलेक्ट्रो ऑस्मोसिस। इन स्पाइट ऑफ द माइग्रेशन ऑफ कोलाइडल पार्टिकल्स मीन्स पार्टिकल्स ऑफ द डिस्पर्स फेज, इफ द माइग्रेशन ऑफ डिस्पर्स पार्टिकल्स ऑफ डिस्पर्स फेज प्रिवेंटेड एंड ओनली माइग्रेशन ऑफ पार्टिकल्स ऑफ डिस्पर्सन मीडियम इज अलाउड टूवर्ड्स पर्टिकुलर इलेक्ट्रोड देन दिस इज नोन एज इलेक्ट्रो ऑस्मोसिस। मीन्स माइग्रेशन ऑफ सॉल्वेंट पार्टिकल्स और डिस्पर्सन मीडियम पार्टिकल्स टूवर्ड्स पर्टिकुलर इलेक्ट्रोड इन द इफेक्ट ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड इज नोन एज इलेक्ट्रो ऑस्मोसिस। सो दीज आर द इलेक्ट्रिकल प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ कोलाइडल सोल्यूशन। Now the very important thing is coagulation. Since collider particles contains either positive or negative charge, so they can be neutralized by adding electrolyte and they get precipitated. So the precipitation of collider particle by adding electrolyte or by the effect of electrolyte is known as coagulation. And the power of an electrolyte to bring about the coagulation or precipitation of colloidal solution is measured in the terms of coagulation value or flocculation value, and it is always measured in millimoles, means number of millimoles of electrolyte required to precipitate 1 liter of colloidal solution is known as coagulation value of the electrolyte or flocculation value of the electrolyte. So how do you define coagulation or flocculation value of electrolyte? Number of millimoles of electrolyte required to coagulate or to precipitate 1 liter of colloidal solution is known as coagulation or flocculation value of electrolyte. With this regard, one important rule is Hardy-Soulier rule. According to Hardy-Soulier rule, the coagulating power of a coagulant, in other words, electrolyte, is directly proportional to its charge. For example, if the electrolyte is NaCl, MgCl2 and AlCl3, there are 3 electrolytes. One is NaCl, sodium chloride, second one is magnesium chloride, and third one is aluminium chloride. In these electrolytes, cation is Na+, Mg++, and Al++. So according to Hardy-Soulier rule, coagulating power of NaCl is less than the coagulating power of MgCl2, which is still less than the coagulating power of AlCl3. It means the coagulating power increases from NaCl to AlCl3. As the positive charge of the cation increases, coagulating power of the electrolyte increases for a particular colloids. Since cation can coagulate negatively charged salt, so for the precipitation of arsenious sulfide salt among NaCl, MgCl2 and AlCl3 is the most efficient electrolyte or coagulant, because in AlCl3 aluminium acquires 3 positive charge, in MgCl2 Mg+2 charge, and NaCl Na+ charge. As the positive charge on the ion increases, their coagulating power to coagulate a negatively charged colloid also increases. This is the first rule of Hardy-Soulier. According to Hardy-Soulier rule, coagulating power of an electrolyte increases with increasing their charge. Just like this, if the colloidal solution is positively charged, means ferric hydroxide salt, just like ferric hydroxide salt, positive colloid, then it can be precipitated or coagulated by negative ions, and as the charge of negative ion increases, means negative charge on the ion increases, their coagulating power also increases. For example, for the precipitation of ferric hydroxide salt, if there are 3 electrolytes, one is NaCl, next ammonium sulfate, and third is ammonium phosphate or sodium phosphate. In case of phosphate, there are 3 negative charges. In case of sulfate, there are only 2 negative charges. And in case of NaCl, Cl only 1 negative charge. As the negative charge increases, coagulating power of the ion increases. So in order to precipitate or coagulate ferric hydroxide salt, the coagulating power of ions increases from Cl negative, SO4 negative and phosphate negative. This is the Hardy-Soulier rule, which is very, very important rule, which explains the coagulating power of an electrolyte or a coagulant. Now the next term is protection of colloids. Since any of the electrolyte can coagulate a colloidal solution, and you know that lyophilic colloids are more stable and reversible, but lyophobic colloids are unstable and irreversible. It means due to the effect of electrolyte or a coagulant, lyophobic colloids gets precipitated very easily, very rapidly, and their precipitation can be prevented or can be protected by lyophilic colloid. So the lyophilic colloid protects the precipitation or coagulation of lyophobic colloid from electrolytes. And the protecting power of a colloidal solution, means lyophilic colloid, is measured in gold number. Gold number, the concept of gold number is given by Zsigmondy, and he defined the term gold number. So what, how will you define gold number? Gold number is the number of milligrams of lyophilic colloid, means protective colloid, which prevents the precipitation of 10 ml of gold salt from 1 ml of 1% NaCl solution, 10% NaCl solution. Suppose this is a gold salt, 10 ml gold salt, this is gold salt. Please note, gold salt is also known as purple of Cassius. Gold salt is also known as purple of Cassius. This is very important question. This is 10 ml gold salt, and this is 10% NaCl solution. 10% NaCl solution, and here is the protective colloid. Suppose x milligram of the protective colloid. When 1 ml of 10% NaCl solution is added to 10 ml of gold salt, when 1 ml of 10% NaCl solution is added to 10 ml of gold salt, then precipitation takes place, means coagulation takes place. But when we add some milligrams, suppose x milligrams of a lyophilic colloid, means protective colloid, in gold salt, and then 1 ml of 10% NaCl solution is added to it, it prevents the precipitation. Okay, in this case, lyophilic salt acts as a protective colloid for gold salt. So this is the meaning of gold number. What is gold number? Number of milligrams of protective colloid required to prevent coagulation of 10 ml of gold salt by 1 ml of 10% NaCl solution is known as gold number. So gold number and flocculation value or coagulation number, these are two important terms in colloidal solution. Now next term is the emulsion. Emulsion is a colloidal solution in which dispersed phase and dispersion medium both are liquids. For example, milk is an example of emulsion. This is very good example of emulsion. And emulsion are of two types: water in oil and oil in water. Means WO type emulsion and OW type emulsion. Micelles are a loosely bound aggregation of atoms, ions, or molecules
फॉर्मिंग ए कोलाइडर पार्टिकल,
फॉर एग्जाम्पल
सोप ऑन डिसोल्यूशन इन वाटर
फॉर्म्स मिसेल, सिंस सोप्स आर सोडियम और पोटेशियम स्टीयरेट, मीन्स दे आर द साल्ट ऑफ सोडियम और पोटेशियम स्टीयरेट, दे हैव टू पार्ट्स, वन इज हाइड्रोकार्बन पोर्शन, अनदर इज पोलर पार्ट विच इज वाटर लविंग, एंड हाइड्रोकार्बन पोर्शन इज वाटर हीटिंग एंड फैट लविंग और डर्ट लविंग। वेन सोप सोल्यूशन इज प्रिपेयर, एन एग्रीगेट ऑफ सोप मॉलिक्यूल्स फॉर्म्स मिसेल, एग्रीगेट ऑफ सोप मॉलिक्यूल्स फॉर्म्स मिसेल, सो दिस इज एग्जाम्पल ऑफ मिसेल एंड ऑल अबाउट द प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ कोलाइडल सोल्यूशन, इमल्शन एंड मिसेल्स। सम अदर इंपॉर्टेंट टर्म्स रिलेटेड टू दिस लेसन इज डायलिसिस एंड पेप्टाइजेशन। डायलिसिस एंड पेप्टाइजेशन, डायलिसिस इज अ मेथड ऑफ प्यूरिफिकेशन ऑफ कोलाइड्स, सिंस कोलाइड्स कैन बी प्रिपेयर्ड बाई डिफरेंट मेथड्स, बाई मैकेनिकल मेथड, बाई ब्रेडिंग आर्क मेथड, बाई ऑक्सीडेशन मेथड, बाई रिडक्शन मेथड, बाई डबल डिकम्पोजिशन मेथड, नंबर ऑफ मेथड्स आर देयर फॉर द यूज फॉर द प्रिपरेशन ऑफ कोलाइडल सोल्यूशन। एनी हाउ इफ द कोलाइडल सोल्यूशन प्रोसेस इम्प्योरिटी दे कैन बी प्यूरिफाइड बाई द प्रोसेस नोन एज डायलिसिस। सो डायलिसिस इज द मेथड यूज फॉर द प्यूरिफिकेशन ऑफ कोलाइडल सोल्यूशन। इन दिस केस कोलाइडल सोल्यूशन विच टू बी प्यूरिफाइड इज टेकन इन डायलाइजर, मीन्स ए बैग ऑफ सेमी परमेबल मेम्ब्रेन। इन दिस केस इट इज कॉल्ड डायलाइजर एंड इट इज हैंग इन रनिंग वाटर, इम्प्यूरिटी गेट्स डिफ्यूज एंड कोलाइडल सोल्यूशन बिकम्स प्योर। दिस मेथड इज नोन एज सिंपल डायलिसिस। It is time taking. If we require quick dialysis, then in place of simple dialysis, electrodialysis is preferred. So what is the difference between electrodialysis and simple dialysis? Electrodialysis is carried out in the presence of electric field, while simple dialysis in the absence of electric field. In both dialysis, colloidal solution is purified, but simple dialysis is time taking while electrodialysis is quick and fast. Peptization. Peptization is another method used to prepare the colloidal solution. In this method, a freshly prepared precipitate of colloidal solution is treated with suitable electrolyte to form colloidal solution. So this is all about surface chemistry. In surface chemistry, there are three parts. One is adsorption. In this topic, you learn about the difference between absorption and adsorption, and physisorption and chemisorption, and some important terms like adsorbate, adsorbent, sorption, desorption, chemisorption, physisorption, all things. In case of catalysis, definition of catalyst and catalysis, types of catalysis, theories of catalysis, with at least one or two examples, each of the term is required. And in colloidal solution, definition of colloid in terms of particle size of particles, and their classification, methods of preparation, properties and applications. So this is all about the surface chemistry. Thank you.